Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. So in the previous video we talked about the filter, so that's a filtering data grid. Now with the data we see defaultly, as soon as you do not specify the type of filter that you're supposed to use or you want to use, the default one is the filter bar, and that is what you see here as a text box. So you see that each has a text box where you can pass in the name or the ID or email. Okay, now if you want to specify the other ones, can we do it? Yes, we can. And what are even the other one that we can actually apply? Let's have a look. So you know, we can actually have a filter bar, and that is what we have here. So we did this in the previous video. Now the next ones, we have other three, that is the menu, checkbox, and extra like. So we can use these three guys here to also implement with the filtering. Let's have a look on this. So what you have to do first here is we can specify with filter settings. Then you specify the type as what? Menu. So syncfusion.blazor.grid.filtertype, we set this to menu. So let's open this. Let's copy this and in here, filter settings. Okay. So with the filter settings, you see we have it here already. We have filter settings here, and that is for search here. Okay. So this is what you want to do. Now this filter settings is going for the default one, like the filter bar. That's what you see. We have filter bar mode. So let's clear this off. Let's pick the one that we have. We're going for the type password, so that's the syncfusion. So syncfusion, the filter type dot menu. So this is going to be menu. Now let's save this. Let's refresh the application. So our page is now loading. Now it's key is check from this side. So see here. So you can see we have a filter icon here. As soon as I click on this, I'm going to have a drop down. So let's click on this. So I have a drop down here. Now, which one do you want to use? Is it equal? So click on this to select. So I have less than, greater than, so equal to, passing the value here. So as you can see from here, you can pass in the value, maybe 2, then filter. You have only this. Okay. Now, the same, if you want to clear that, just click on clear to get it off. The same applies to the first name. So yeah, start with. So you see that an end with or content, passing the value here as F. Now you see we have Frank being popped up. The same thing applies to this one. Okay, so start with. Now with email, to have the same start with. So we see from this number doesn't, the ID doesn't have start with because it has these operators, because it's a number. Now these are strings or text. So start with, end with, contain, it has it. Okay. Alright, so that is the filter menu. Let's apply the other one as well. That is going to be the next one. So let's see which is the next one that you want to apply. Let's apply the checkbox. So let's go in there. And now in here, with the filter menu, we clear this off. And now we are going for checkbox. So let's use the checkbox. Let's save this. Let's refresh application. Alright, so our page is now loaded. So let's click on also the filter icon. And now we can see that there is a checkbox. So this we've selected all. So that's a select all. You can select the specific one that you actually want to. So click on filter. You have that specific one being selected. And I can see this one is currently blue because that's the activated one. Can click on this, and I can see we have select what? John. So select all John. Because we've done the selected or the filter here. So let's clear filter. Now we have all. So the same applies to the first name. You can see all names have been selected. You can decide to choose the one that you would not like to check because you have the specific ones. With the email too, you have exactly the same. So clear filtering, clear, and now let's go in there. So we have all emails. You can actually now select it and now click on filter. You have all. Now let's talk about the last one, and that's going to be with the Excel. So it is going to have an Excel lookalike, Excel sort interface. So let's have a look at that. Now in here in application, we have to specify here, instead of the checkbox, you're going for the last one, that is the Excel, because we've talked about all this except the Excel. So let's click on this. Now let's save this. Let's refresh our application. Let's save it again. Refresh. So our page is now loaded. And now we see we have the same icon. When you click on the icon, we have an Excel lookalike. So you can see number filtering. So you see we have less than custom filter. So we can actually customize the filtering as well. So you can customize it. Okay, this is the customizing. So you can customize your filtering, or you can actually use the other ones as indicated here. If you want to actually search, you can pass in 5 and you have that. So 5, you have it. Number filtering, you have less than 5. Then less than, can customize that over here. Okay, the same applies to the names. So text filtering, you can actually do that, or you can select all. So if you don't want to select all, let's click on that. Let's search for A. Now you see we have all A being selected. You can decide to select and select all, then select the specific one that you want, click on OK, and you have that data here. The same thing applies to the other. So you see that the Excel here is an advanced. The Excel is an advanced filtering. So clear filter, can clear that filter over here as well. As you can see from email too, can do the same. So I believe this is clear, and that is it for this video. So you see, using the SF data grid or the sync fusion data grid is excellent, the most powerful component that you can actually use to organize your data into pigeon, filtering, grouping, and etc. Name what you can, or name what you want, and you're gonna have it in the sync fusion data component. Thank you guys for watching. We're gonna move on to the next one. So interesting, you go for a break. When we return, we move there. So see you.